evening at the Dania Highline Fronton, Milford's Azca and Boniguin were on the verge of upsetting Miami's Joey and Elorduy in game two of the National Highline Championship. With the score 20-19, Milford leading, Azca caught Joey's serve, threw a devastating carom to win the 21-point match and send the best-of-three series to a final game to determine the national championship. Tonight, it'll be Milford versus Miami on Miami's home court, coming right up. From the Miami Highline Fronton, Miami, Florida. On TV, a service of national subscription television, Miami Fort Lauderdale presents the NAJF National Highline Championship. Tonight, the final game in the best of three series between Milford and Miami. Hello, everybody. I'm Marty Fleischman, and we're here at the beautiful Miami Highline Fronton to bring you the final game in the best of three series between Milford, Connecticut and Miami, Florida. For those of you that tuned in Sunday, on TV presented game number two. It was a mild upset. The Milford team beat the Miami team 21-19 to send it into this final game. My broadcast partners tonight, Kevin Koffman, who will be doing the analysis of the Miami team, and Steve Bourie, who will handle the Milford side of it. Steve, it had to be a great confidence builder for the Milford team to pull that 21-19 victory and get into this finals.
Yes, I think so, Marty. A lot of people after the first game here at Miami Highline wrote off the Milford team. They lost 21-12, but they came back. They proved that they could win. Azca had a good night. Joey had a bad night. So they have the confidence now and know that anything can happen here tonight.
Kevin, it's true. Joey did have an off night, and it had to kind of be shaking him a little bit to come into this final game knowing that he lost the last game. What effect is it going to have on the Miami team?
Well, Joey definitely did not have one of his finer partidos during the last match. He knows he played badly. He knows that he has to improve a great deal to beat this Milford team that had really has shown a great deal of promise the last partido. They both played well. Elorduy, we didn't play that badly during the last partido. We're going to look for a good performance from him. As we know, when money's on the line, Joey is usually at his best.
We're going to see what kind of champion Joey really is when he comes in this final game tonight. This tournament started way back in December. There were eight cities represented. Now we're down to two. Let's see how they got there to the finals.
It was the first time that the top players from eight different frontons gathered to face each other on the same court. At stake, $25,000 in prize money and the prestige of national champion. Fans from Orlando followed their team of Saeed and Mindy around the state. Their hearts were big, but it was not enough. Young stars such as Daytona Beach's Incline found that early tournament jitters can prove costly. Seen here against Orlando's Saeed and Mindy, Incline showed that the Daytona Beach team could not be taken lightly and would definitely be a team to be reckoned with next year. Newport, Rhode Island's duo of Lopetegui and Mindia could have been called the Over the Hill Gang since both veterans were in their mid-30s. But their patience and experience showed and kept them in the hunt to the very end. They failed to qualify by a single point. One of the pre-tournament favorites had to be Dania's Waristi and Andranua. While fans waited for them to make a stretch run, it just never happened, and they finished a disappointing seventh place. When the smoke cleared, Miami, Milford, Tampa, and Palm Beach would make the playoffs. In the semifinals, Palm Beach stars Saez and Laca squared off against Miami's Joey and Elorduy, seen here in red. Joey, substituting for the starting front quarter Otera, who went down with an injury earlier, showed why he is one of the top players in the world. Though Saez and Laca attempted to keep the ball deep away from Joey, they still had to contend with a cannon in the backcourt, the hard-throwing Elorduy. The Palm Beach team found the Miami pair overpowering and lost the best of three semifinals in two straight. Miami was in the finals. Meanwhile, Tampa and Milford, Connecticut were battling to see who would make the finals against Miami. Milford, seen here in blue, had injury problems of their own when star front quarter Zuleika scratched almost midway in the tournament. Facing Tampa's Adamayo and Arcarazo II, Milford had a very strong front man, Azca, and a back quarter named Boninguen, who amazed the crowds with his dramatic saves. It was a duel between the smooth Adamayo and the aggressive Azca, neither wanting to lose the battle. The best of three series went to the limit, neither team giving ground. After all, this was a shot at the national championship. Boninguen kept the Tampa team off balance. Azca could smell victory. Finally, it was over. Milford the winner, and nobody wanted it more than front quarter Azca. So it would be Milford against Miami for the national championship. In Partido 1 of the best of three finals, more than 4,000 fans at the Miami Fronton cheered and chanted, urging their team on against the visitors from Milford, Connecticut, seen here in blue. The 21-point match was dead even at the midway point. Then Miami's Joey and Elorduy got hot, ran eight straight points, and soundly defeated Azca and Boninguen 21-12 to take a one-up lead in the championship series. The finals moved to Dania with Milford in a must-win situation. Azca, Milford's talented front man, played aggressively. The back man, Boninguen, flawless. The Milford team took an early lead and went on to win 21-19. It was a disappointing loss for the Miami team. A great victory for Milford. Miami will have the home court advantage, but Milford is on a roll. It all comes down to this, the final game for the national title.
We'll be back for the first serve in this championship final right after this. We're back here at the Miami High Life Fronton. It's the third and final partido in this best of three series for the national championship. They've already played two. The first one, Miami won 21-12. Milford came back last week and upset the Miami team by a score of 21-19. Miami definitely did not have a good night, Kevin.
That's right, Marty. As we said earlier, Joey had one of the worst nights in quite some time, and I spoke to him about that earlier tonight. Not your best performance in the last partido held at Dania. Joey, what have you done to prepare yourself better for this final match?
Well, I feel I had a bad night and put it behind me and just practice a little, get ready, prepared some baskets, and I'm just mentally and physically very ready for this game.
Steve, what do you think that win last week did for the Milford team?
Well, Marty, certainly after last Saturday's win, the Milford team has to be confident. I spoke to Boninguen about that. Boninguen, you lost the first game. You came in, you won the second game. Here it's the third and deciding game. Are you confident?
Well, I believe we are pretty confident to do our best. I don't know about... I'm not thinking of winning. I'm just thinking of playing good. That's all.
We're seconds away now from the first serve here in the final 21-point partido. It's a head-to-head match, Miami against Milford. For those fans that aren't familiar with a partido, which is just a head-to-head game, 21 points, partido rules can be a little different than normal highlight rules. They will be allowed one overserve. If you do overserve, you get another serve, but the second serve must be good. An underserve is an automatic loss of point. There is carom serves, or serves that hit two walls, that are allowed in partido play. You may see some carom serves tonight. The Milford team has won the toss, and they will be in the blue shirts opposed to. They have elected to serve. It's Azca and Boninguen representing Milford, Connecticut, one of the newest frontons in the United States, going against
the veteran Joey, championships too numerous to mention, and a youngster, Elorduy, 21 years old, Mexican. Outstanding backcourter who is definitely destined for stardom. They will be in the red shirts of post one, Joey and Elorduy. This will be the final game, and it will determine the national champion in the sport of highlight. Azca preparing to serve. I would say, Steve, that the Milford team is probably looking again for the deadest balls to try to eliminate Elorduy's strength in the backcourt.
Well, while sometimes you think they'd want a dead ball to eliminate some of Elorduy's strength or counterbalance it, you'd also think sometimes he would want a lively ball in case he wants to try that carom serve, Marty.
Well, there's no doubt that when Joey and Elorduy win the serve, they will choose the fastest ball possible. The crowd is already getting into this match and cheering this Miami. This is a home crowd for the Miami team, cheering Joey and Elorduy on. I wonder if they're going to get into their moaning as they did every time Elorduy threw that ball over speeds of 150 miles an hour. The game is now on. The serve is good. Azca and Boninguen in the blue shirts. They are already into it. You can hear the crowd. And Miami's on the board. The rebote, they didn't come out. Point to Miami. They score first.
I think it's important for both of the teams to get through one or two points of. Here's the first serve by Azca. And it was a good serve, feeding Elorduy on the right side. I thought that they'd come out just trying to volley a little bit and get a feel of the court. That ball dropped down a little bit, and Boney couldn't make the rebote.
Boninguen seems to have trouble getting started. He has had a couple of missed balls earlier in the first couple of points of partidos. Then he settles down and doesn't miss a ball the rest of the partido. That ball really was right to him, and he just fanned on the rebote. Rebote shot is the ball that comes off the back wall. You'll hear us repeating that phrase, rebote, all evening. Any shot coming off the back wall is a rebote. Joey, his first serve of the evening. That serve is taken by Azca. Dejada, change of pace. Joey's going to get there for it, and he throws outside. A great catch by Azca. And out of Elorduy's cesta, he can't make the play. It's Milford 1, Miami 1. That was a beautiful shot by Azca that scores. Steve?
Well, once again, Azca looks like he's going to be playing an aggressive game. He cut off the serve. We caught it here after he returned Joey's outside placement.
That was a well-played volley. These volleys have not lasted very long, but that was filled with kill shots. A change of pace shot by Azca off the serve, and then Joey getting to it, throwing that outside placement, Azca making the stab. It's 1-1. That serve is good. Elorduy deep in the backcourt with his hard forehand shot. Boninguen brings it in. That ball tipped the overhead screen by Boninguen. It's Miami 2, Milford 1. And that is an example of being used to the Dania court where the screen is much higher.
I think Boninguen's going to need one or two points where he really can get used to the court. These first 3 points of the partido have been over relatively quickly, and I think he does need just a bit of time to adjust.
The Dania overhead screen where Boninguen is used to playing is a lot higher than at Miami, and he's going to have to bring that reverse shot down lower. Joey's serve is good. 2-1 lead for Miami. Reverse catch by Joey. Rebote shot coming out. Azca sets up. Rebote will go to Joey. This could be a kill shot. He goes two walls with it and scores. Miami now a 2-point lead, 3-1. It looked like Joey was setting up to go inside with it, and at the last moment, Kevin, I would have to say that he decided to go two walls.
This was a decision he took here. Again, that throw by Azca clipped the side wall, allowing Joey to take the ball on his reverse, and I think you're right, Marty. I think he made up his mind just at the last moment. It could have been a deadly mistake if he had gone through at the inside. Azca was waiting there for him.
This is a home court advantage for Joey and Elorduy being at Miami. And there's no doubt they'll be more relaxed on this court, and Joey will be able to throw his shots. Joey's serving with a 2-point lead. It's going to 21 points. It's now 3-1. Elorduy. Rotate coming out. Boninguen sets up. That's a good shot. Fine catch by Elorduy. And a good catch by Boninguen. Joey will Joey cannot make the play on that ball. It seemed to float. His timing was off, and Milford scores. It's 3-2.
Marty, it looks like everybody's a little bit nervous at this point. They seem to be missing easy balls and making simple mistakes. Here on the reverse by Boninguen, comes right back to Joey right in the middle of the court, and he misses it. I think they're all still a little bit nervous.
Timing slightly off on that. You know, they're playing for $25,000 in total prize money. $11,000 goes to the winning team, $5,000 to the second place team, and the prestige of a national championship. Milford serving now. Azca's serve will be taken by Joey. He goes two walls with it. Azca has it. Azca goes inside with it. Just narrow and missing Joey, and Elorduy cannot come down with it. Milford scores. It's tied up 3-3. That was a pretty dangerous throw. As you can see, Azca went ahead and threw that ball low. They're letting out the shaft in this partido. There's no doubt about it. They're going to go all the way with it. Elorduy could not come down with that ball. Joey is at the back of the court going to the towel.
Once again, Joey cuts off the service, and he throws the remate. It was not a good remate. It didn't cut out all the way. The remate being when he cuts it off and sends it backhand into the side wall and then into the front wall and then out towards the screen. And it didn't quite cut out far enough, and Azca was there, and he just returned a carambola.
A little bit of early partido jitters here for Elorduy. That's two in a row. Joey has thrown out. Not bad shots. That shot even might have been an attempt to split the middle just a bit, catch Azca going outside. Even though Azca did catch the ball, that should have been a ball that Elorduy could come up with.
The fans that saw the last partido match on TV broadcast on Sunday, they saw Azca and Boninguen play outstanding highlight. Azca exceptionally well, being very aggressive and winning at 21-19. There's a carom serve. Joey's waiting for it. He just drives it deep to the backcourt, but the rebote shot will come out to Azca. That serve did not catch Joey by surprise, and that ball just goes right by Elorduy. He misses it. Milford has the lead by 1-4-3. Not a very well-played point on the Miami team's part, as Elorduy's timing again off and missing that pelota.
There's the rebote by Azca. It was right to Elorduy, right to his right side there. Its timing just seemed to be off, and it went right by him.
If there's any weakness on the Miami team, it's Elorduy trying to go for all the balls on his forehand side, or the right side, as they say. That ball he could have taken with his backhand easier, and he tried to go with his forehand catch. Milford with a one-point lead, 4-3. Boninguen's backhand shot. Elorduy setting up, throwing a hard back forehand shot to Boninguen's reverse. Rebote shot coming out. This is one of Joey's best shots. That rebote is going right along the sidewall. Good catch by Boninguen. Elorduy pumping hard that forehand. Just barely on the court. A good save by Boninguen. There's a soft carom shot. Joey going up. Reverse catch. Remate. Azca has it, and he throws it inside. A diving effort by Elorduy, but no good. Milford gets another point. They have a two-point lead, 5-3.
That time we saw some good highlight, Marty. Joey came up, got very aggressive. He cut off a ball that he could have let go for his backcourt partner. Here it is on the replay. Boninguen throws a high carom from the backcourt. Joey comes up. He cuts it off. This ball he could have easily let go. Tries to throw the remate. It was a good remate, but Azca was caught it way up front and comes back with a carambola. Low and hard shot, and Elorduy just can't hold on to it. And the point goes to Milford.
I'll be honest with you, Marty. Here's another look at it. Joey threw that remate with relative nonchalance, and I think he thought he had the point won. He turned around. There's Azca with the ball in his cesta, threw back carambola, and Elorduy with a good effort, but a good shot by Azca on the return of a well-thrown ball.
Great position by Milford's front quarter, Azca, as he darted to the outside, caught Joey when he threw the remate shot two walls and put him away. It is now a two-point lead for the Milford team, 5-3. Joey has left the court and is returning now, trying to break the momentum of the Milford team, who has run some points. They'll have to stop Milford before they get too many, because this thing could get out of hand, and it's to 21 points, but it's hard to overtake once you get a lead. It'll be tough to overtake a team. They'll get momentum on their side.
During the first game, the one that Miami won, 21-12, didn't it start rather close like this?
It did. Then it was tied up at 11 before Miami ran 8 straight points and won that match. The partido in Dania last week was tied at 12 apiece. It got about a 1 or 2 point lead all the way through, and then Milford ended up winning. Oscar's serve is good. Lord Dewey takes it with a forehand. Three-quarter shot. Boniguin pulls it in. Ribote shot will come out. Joey sets up. Elorduy is going to take it. Throws a hard Ribote. Oscar brings it down. Cortada shot low and hard. Joey has it. Joey driving it to the back wall. Ball will come out. Oscar setting up forehand. Elorduy makes the catch. So be a tough catch for Boniguin, who takes it. Joey pulls this one off the sidewall. Oscar setting up. Ribote shot coming inside. A tough catch. A good catch by Elorduy. That ball just missing the overhead screen. Joey setting up. The Ribote. A good catch by Boniguin. He fakes the carom shot. Joey comes inside. Catches the ball. Good catch by Boniguin. Joey again scraping off the sidewall. Now that ball going deep. A fine effort. A good save. Joey in the front court goes low into the inside and scores. Miami gets the point. A fine shot by Joey. A good effort by Milford's Azca, but Miami pulls within 1 point.
A bit more intensity out of the Miami team on that play. Joey making a few fine catches at the sidewall and just doing what he had to do to keep the ball in play and allow himself a chance to win the point, which he did with that cortado or low and hard shot back inside.
That was a much better point than we've seen in the earlier points tonight. Both teams seem to be loosening up a bit. Joey playing that point extremely well, and Oscar still playing as well as he did last week, Steve.
I think so. Marty hasn't made too many mistakes yet.
He's still playing the aggressive ball. Let's see, the turning point we all agreed on last week had to be the serving. Oscar taking a lot of Joey's serves, and let's see if Joey can keep the serve away from Oscar tonight.
And we've already seen one carom serve this evening.
That's
Joey
right.
Was there, he cut it off.
Haven't seen a carom serve out of Joey yet.
Right.
Let's see if he sets one up. That serve is good. Not a carom serve. 1 point lead by Milford. That ball comes out, and Oscar cannot make the play. Miami scores again, and the score is now tied at 5.
It was a good effort by Oscar on this play. You can see the ball here to Boniguin on the reverse. Remember, now he's trying to get that ball away from Joey. That also hits a little crack in the wall, goes to Joey on the reverse. Sends it deep against the wall. Boniguin caught a little out of position. Oscar with a fine, almost a great save there. If he had made that, that would have been a tremendous save, and we're tied at 5.
Looked like Oscar thought that his backcourt partner, Boniguin, was going to take that ball and got caught when Boniguin decided to let it go at the last minute. That serve is good. Oscar unable to take Joey's serve. That ball, a mix up in communication. Elorduy recovered well, though. So go to Joey. Joey with his reverse shot. And out of Boniguin's cesta, it is now 6-5. Miami takes the lead. A seesaw battle here at the Miami Fronton.
Here we can see, there's Boniguin back in the corner around the 14 line. That's right at the back wall. Joey with a fine reverse. Now this ball, once it hits the ground, takes a short hop bounce. Boniguin kind of gets jammed and can't hang on.
Crowd now cheering the Miami team on. Joey preparing the serve. Remember, he gets 2 serves if it's an overserve, and he does overserve. He'll get another one. You lose the point on an underserve, but they do allow 1 overserve in partido play.
On that last play, Marty, we saw Elorduy go straight overhand. I think that was the hardest shot he's thrown yet tonight. We hadn't really seen much power out of him, and perhaps he was just trying to loosen that arm up.
Elorduy has had some injury problems, which we'll go into later. Joey now preparing to serve his second serve. That one is good. 1 point lead by the Miami team. That's an overhand shot. Elorduy comes up on it, takes a forehand. He sends that one deep with pretty good power. Boniguin pulls a good shot down. Joey will have it in the front court. Joey, being a little conservative, sends it deep to the back court. That Ribote shot will come out to Joey, way out. keeps that one into the side wall. Has a good catch by Boni. Another rebote shot. Joey setting up. Another good rebote. And a great catch that time by Boniguin. And Joey, another. Boniguin. Elorduy with a forehand. Trying to drive it by Oscar. He does. That comes out of Boniguin Cesta. A two-point lead for the Miami team. That was all. Rebotes by Joey, catches by Boniguin, and finally Elorduy throws one of his devastating shots coming out of Boniguin's cesta.
You can see on this replay that the strategy of the Miami team is to keep the ball to Boniguin on the reverse. A series of catches and throws to Boniguin on the reverse. Here comes an Elorduy right side, and this time the ball just rolls out of the tip of Boniguin's basket.
The score is now 7-5. Miami with a two-point lead. And Oscar's having trouble getting into the point, Steve.
Yeah, we saw him cut off more of the serves last week. Joey's doing an effective job of keeping the serve away from him tonight.
Looks like they're keeping the ball to Boniguin. And if Oscar can't get into the volleys, it looks like the Milford team's going to be in trouble. He's the one, he's the point scorer. Fortunately, Miami is able to, for their sake at least, is able to have strength in the backcourt. Joey and Elorduy are capable of scoring. And the only thing that Boniguin can really throw from the backcourt is that long carom, which does score occasionally, but we haven't seen too many in the last couple of partidos.
No, we just saw the one tonight, and there weren't any in last week's
Miami
partido.
Winning. Miami is winning 7-5 now. That's an overserve. They'll get another.
Miami's reeled off four straight points, and those four straight points came after four straight points run off by Milford. So they're trading groups of four.
Second serve coming up for the Miami team. This serve must be good. Joey taking his time. He knows that he's got to keep this ball. He has to keep this ball away from Azca. And he does. Two-point lead for the Miami team. Here comes Joey's patented rebote shot. That's a fine rebote shot. It'll come way out. Boniguin setting up. Oscar's setting up now. That's a good shot. It'll come to Elorduy's forehand. Throwing it deep. Boniguin back in position. Another shot coming off the back wall. And another good shot by Joey. But Boniguin pulls it down. Off balance slightly. Joey goes up and takes it.
Over his head right now.
Azca cannot make that forehand rebote a three-point lead for the Miami team, 8-5.
I think the Miami team is now using what we could call conservative strategy, keeping the ball in play, and I think Joey has told his backcourt partner, Elorduy, let me worry about the kill shots, you just keep the ball on the court. Here Joey with a reverse inside. Conservative shot, but at the same time an offensive shot. As long as you keep that opponent deep, the ball comes out, and Azca with a fall down attempted save that he couldn't get.
Milford team seems to have lost the rhythm right now. Joey approaches the line with a lead, and that serve is good. Great catch of the serve by Boniguin, who had to go up in the air for that. Joey brings it down. It's Joey to Azca, and a save by Azca. Joey lets that go to Elorduy. Elorduy sending it deep. Fine catch by Boniguin. This will clear Elorduy. This is going to be a tough play and a good rebote shot. Azca now on the offense, driving it deep, and Elorduy pulls it down. Great catch off the sidewall by Azca. Joey pulls down a good reverse. And that tipped Azca Cesta. Miami scores again. Azca trying to one-hand it with his reverse side and misses. It's Miami now extending their lead.
This is a good exchange between the teams. Azca with a very good catch here at the sidewall with a ball that had a lot of steam on it. Joey caught this ball, perhaps could have thrown a remonte, but chooses to go back inside. Azca flying through the air, sticks his hand out, and can't pull it down.
Score is 9-5. Steve, I wonder what the Milford team is going to do to get back into this partido.
I don't know, Marty, but it seems like everyone's playing catch. And maybe the Miami team has decided, since they're playing a better game of catch, that they should continue to play that way. No one's throwing shots.
I am surprised that Joey is playing as conservative as he is. That is true, and I think Oscar's going to open up if he can just get his Sesta on the ball to throw some of the shots. Now the score still 9-5. There's been a slight delay in the action, as it looks like the Milford team is trying to break the momentum of Miami.
An interesting thing, Marty, about Boniguan. They seem to be throwing a lot of balls to Boniguan in the backcourt. Now here at Miami Highline, the screen is lower. It's lower than at Dania. So Boniguan at Dania, because he's not as powerful as Elorduy, he could just lift the ball and get it all the way to the back wall. Here he can't do that, because if he were to try to lift the ball, he would hit the screen. So he is in a little bit of trouble here. He doesn't have the ability to just lift with his backhand and send it to the back wall.
That's one of the advantages of the home court. The reason they're playing here at Miami Highline, this third and final partido, is Miami had accumulated the most points after the two partidos. The partidos were split 1-1. Miami had scored the most. They get the home court advantage in this third and final partido.
Steve, if you're looking for a spark to be lit on this Milford squad, who do you think it would come from? Would it come from Oscar, or maybe Boniguan with a carom or something like that?
It's got to come from Oscar. I think he's got to cut the serve off.
Score is now 9-5. Oscar takes the serve. Joey setting up with Ribolte. Ribolte carom. Oscar cannot hang on to it. Miami gets another. It's 10-5. One of the few times Joey has thrown that Ribolte carom shot that hit two walls. Oscar was waiting for it.
Here's Joey with the Ribolte carom, and Oscar had that ball. That's a lucky break for Miami, because I think he could have returned to reverse, at least kept the ball in play. Just tipped off his basket.
A 5-point lead for the Miami team. Again, the ball coming off the back wall. Joey deciding to go two walls with it. A lot of power on that ball. Oscar leaping, trying to catch it. You can see Joey ducking, trying to keep away from that. That's 7 straight points for the Miami team. The most they've run in these partido matches has been 8. Joey approaching the service line. 10-5. Serve is good. Boniguan takes it with a forehand, trying to high bounce it, but Elorduy charges it. Elorduy sending it deep to the back. Boniguan has it. He'll send it deep, trying to get it over both players' heads. Elorduy, the Ribolte shot. Is that sailing on? It stays on the court. Elorduy now, again, trying to get it over Boniguan's head. This will go wall to wall. Oscar. Oscar's Ribolte carom is wide on the wood. That's out of bounds. Milford will lose the point. Miami, the 8. That's the 8th consecutive point for Miami. It is now 11-5.
Marty, those are the chances that Oscar's going to have to take. Boniguan here trying to send this ball, wants it to get to the sidewall before Elorduy can catch it, but he does not. And on this shot again, Elorduy is now starting to air it out and throw the ball as hard as he can. If Oscar throws this ball with a little bit less English, that ball's on the court and goes for a winner, but instead, Miami, as you say, has gotten its 8th consecutive point.
Joey's serve at 11-5. Oscar backing up, taking the serve, trying to change the momentum here. A high bounce. This is going to be trouble, and it scores. A fine play by Oscar. The Milford team breaks Miami's streak of points, and it is now 11-6.
Well, this is what we said Oscar would have to do. He'd have to get a little bit aggressive and get in there and cut off that serve. Here he chose to back up and makes the piccata, the high bounce, and just gets it over Elorduy's head. Good effort by Elorduy, but it was just a little bit over his head, over the tip of his cesta.
That was a fine play by Oscar by backing up on Joey's serve to take that serve and break the momentum. Oscar now approaching the service line. His serve is good. Elorduy takes it with the forehand. Drives it deep to Boniguan. Joey lets it go to Elorduy. Oscar will pull this down with his right side. He's trying to high bounce that one. Elorduy charges and can't make the play. It looks like he just took his eye off of it. That's 2 points in a row for the Milford team, 11-7. And the momentum may be changing in this match.
Here we see on the replay, Elorduy with the forehand. Comes out to Oscar. Oscar takes it with his forehand. Here he is again, tries the pica, the piccata, the high bounce. Elorduy rushing in, but he can't hold on. He misses it.
Score again is 11-7. The partido is to 21 points. Miami with a 4-point lead.
How tall is Elorduy, Marty?
Elorduy is 6'3". But when that cesta is up there, How high do you think he gets?
Plus he can climb the wall. He can get up there about 9-10 feet, I would imagine.
That's right. I would say so. There's a serve by Azca. Serve is good. Elorduy now with a hard overhand shot. That's a super catch by Azca off the side wall. Elorduy is really pumping now. Boniguin pulls it in. This ball will go wall to wall. Joey setting up the rebote. A fall down rebote. That one will come to Azca in the front court. A carom shot. Joey's waiting for it. Takes the carom. Goes two walls with it and scores. Miami gets the points 12-7. That was the Ramate two-wall kill shot that Joey threw. He had the angle because Azca threw the carom. Joey was waiting for it through the two walls.
This is the best Ramate we've seen. Azca with a good carom. Joey backing up, taking it on the reverse. And a very good return, Ramate. Good shot there. Azca had no chance. Without a doubt, the best Ramate we've seen from Joey so far in the series. Azca had a good idea. Joey read him, though. Saw him cock that arm, lined up. There's his favorite shot, Ramate. And Miami gets the point.
That ball actually hit about 3 inches above that lower red cushion, which would have been a loss of point. Joey cutting it very close. The score, 12-7. Miami leading. A good serve. Boniguin pulls it down to the back wall. That's a good catch by Joey off the sidewall. Elorduy with his forehand shot. Fakes the carom. Azca runs outside. The ball stays inside. Elorduy pulling it down. Just driving it deep. Boniguin cannot pull that one down, and it is Miami getting another point. It is 13-7. Boniguin just coughing that ball out of his cesta.
I think Elorduy used a little bit of brain on this play. He tried to make Boniguin think he was going to rifle the ball. Instead, he took a little something off it. Here he goes from the right, fakes like he's going to whip, and instead throws a little bit sidearm. The ball not going as fast as Boniguin perhaps thought it would, and consequently couldn't hang on.
You think, Kevin, that Elorduy is having problems with that wrist?
Well, you know, Marty, Mike Dolan, the trainer, told me that Elorduy, in fact, has a hyperextension of his wrist, and he's still playing. He said many players couldn't even be playing in such pain.
Looks like he's throwing pretty hard out there, but not as hard as usual. It's 13-7. Elorduy now with a forehand outside placement. Oscar's right there. He takes it, drives it deep to the backcourt. This ball will come out to Joey. That's trouble. High bounce. Boniguin pulls it down. Joey at the tip of the basket. Hits two walls going wide out of Boniguin's cesta. Miami gets the point. It's 14-7. That was a pretty lucky shot by Joey. He didn't mean to tip the side wall on it, and it went wide, and Boniguin could not bring it in.
We call those the lucky crack shots in highlight. Boniguin here on the reverse, a fine catch flying through the air. Joey catches this ball. He wants it to stay on the sidewall. Instead, this hits right in the crack and is heading out of bounds. Boniguin with a fine effort, but he can't come up with it.
That type of shot surprises the backcourt men because they're playing it to go inside and skim the sidewall. When it catches the crack of the wall and goes wide, it breaks their timing, and it's very difficult to pull in. Azca now takes the serve, driving it deep. Elorduy waiting for it. A carom shot that goes too low. Milford will score. It is 14-8. That carom by Elorduy going astray and hit the lower cushion.
Once again, Azca gets a little bit aggressive. He backs up to cut off the serve. He's having trouble standing in between the 4 and 7 line and getting the serve, so he backs up for it. And then he throws a low and hard shot, and Elorduy catches it very easily. He throws the carom, but it's just too low, and it hits the red cushion.
The score of the partido now, 14-8, Miami with a 6-point lead. I wonder if Fernando Orbea, the player manager of the Milford team, might have given Azca some advice on how to take Joey's serve if he can't pick it off in the air. That's an overserve. He'll serve another. 14-8. Miami winning. 7 points away from a national title and the first ever national highlight championships. 8 cities participated. Now they're down to Milford, Connecticut versus Miami, Florida. That is going to be an overserve. That is a critical mistake. You get 2 serves, that's like double faulting in tennis. It will be 15-8. Miami now with a 7-point lead.
Marty, there's really no excuse for missing 2 consecutive serves. The first one, as we say, just like in tennis, you're trying to power the ball in. The second one sounds a lot easier than it really is to put that ball in. But still a critical mistake, especially at this juncture of the partido.
Joey now preparing to serve. 15-8 the score. This time Azca does not back up. Serve is going deep to Boniguin. Elorduy with a forehand shot. Momentum is on Miami. That's a great pickup by Boniguin. That's trouble. Elorduy brings it in. Another great catch by Boniguin, keeping them in this point. Rebote shot. Joey, a deep rebote. Another trouble. Beautiful catch. Joey again. Miami on the offense. Boniguin keeping Milford in here. High bounce. Elorduy up the wall. Comes down with it. Good catch by Boniguin. So bounce high again, and this time it clears Elorduy. Milford scores.
Boniguin certainly played some excellent highlight in that point.
Excellent highlight. Boniguin kept the Milford team in that point. It's 15-9. Beautiful save by Elorduy, but that one high bounces over Elorduy's head.
There was Elorduy on the replay going up for the picada. He cuts that off. Throws it back. Here's Boniguin. And he decides to throw a real high ball here, just to try and keep it right down the side wall with a big bounce. And he succeeds in getting it over Elorduy's head. Elorduy comes up, but it's just over his head.
Boniguin, a very graceful backcourter. When he goes up for that ball, he looks like a ballet dancer. There's Joey and Elorduy. Joey, the top American player in the world, and many think the top highlight player in the world. Elorduy, a young Mexican player, 21 years old, up-and-coming star.
I think one thing in that conference that Joey and Elorduy had just a moment ago that we showed, perhaps Joey's telling his young backcourter, let's just keep the ball on the court, not get too fancy, nothing too exotic, and we'll win this thing.
Well, with the score 15-9 and 6 points away from big victory, the Milford team is definitely going to have to win some points here. Otherwise, it's going to be all over. Azca serving. Keeps it away from Joey. Elorduy. Boniguin. Long carom shot by Boniguin. Joey has it at the screen. He goes inside with it, and that ball scores. Miami now taking a 16-9 lead.
Well, we've been waiting for that shot. A shot that Boniguin throws exceptionally well. I think Joey knew in the back of his mind that sometime it was going to have to be coming because the Milford team needed to pull out some of the stops. Boniguin there rips the carom. And it was a good one. He just didn't get the bounce that he needed. If it had bounced higher, it perhaps would have gone over Joey's head. He catches it and throws a soft, low and hard shot inside and wins the point.
Steve, would you say that was one of Boniguin's finer carom shots in the backcourt, or did Joey just play that one well?
Joey happened to be in the right spot. He saw that one coming. I'd have to give credit to Joey.
Serve is good in this 16-9. Elorduy brings it down. Now Azca has it in the front court. Cortada shot. Elorduy has it. Oh! That's out of the system. Azca cannot catch that one. It is 17-9. The Miami team 4 points away from victory.
I don't know if perhaps this ball could have been let go to Boniguin. I don't know if it would have bounced. Azca tries a soft, low and hard shot here, hoping it'll hit the sidewall and bounce down. It comes out to Elorduy, who throws not a hard shot inside, but just enough for Azca to go in the air and have it tip off his basket.
Looks like Azca is just trying to make something happen, going after balls to try to get in this partido. Joey's serve is good at 17-9. Miami in the lead. Ball comes right to Joey. Boniguin. Elorduy wisely letting it go, making a forehand rebote. Goes off the court onto the wood, loses the point. Milford scores. 17-10. That rebote shot just went astray.
Let's see if we can see this on the replay, Marty. Here's Joey with the backhand. Boniguin with his backhand. This is where it comes out to Elorduy. He's sort of on the wall there. He had the side wall in the way, and it just clipped the side wall and went out of bounds on the wood, and it hit the front.
It's now a 7-point lead, 17-10. Partido is to 21 points. Azca approaching the service line. That's a carom serve, and Joey cannot come down with it. It's 17-11. That ball actually almost hit directly in the crack. It caught the sidewall first, hit the front wall, curved at Joey. It jammed him a little bit, Steve. It looked like he didn't think it was going to curve at him.
Right. I don't think Azca was really trying a carom serve there. I think he just caught the sidewall first and made it bounce out a little bit, so it was kind of hard to tell where it was going to go.
The Milford team now on the move, 17-11, trying to get back in this 21-point partido. A six-point lead for Miami. Azca approaching a line. Another half carom. And that scores. That eighth caught seven. The Miami team at ace. It is now 17-12. Confusion on the Miami team's part.
Marty, I think one of the reasons there was such a confusion on that play is we could see on the court. Let's see if we got it in the shot. Elorduy is playing around in the backcourt. He's faking to Azca, and I think Joey saw him go back there, and he just wasn't there for the ball. He was playing a little cat and mouse game, kind of trying to get Oscar's vision that he was right behind him looking for a carom serve. And Joey, I think, also saw that. But at that time, Elorduy had gone back to the sidewall.
It's 17-12, a five-point lead for Miami. And if he was playing cat and mouse, he was actually asleep, because that ball went wide and he wasn't anywhere near that ball.
It's debatable whether or not he threw that on purpose. I can't tell. Do you think he really threw that on purpose, that carom serve?
I didn't think the last point he did, but that's the second point in a row that he tried it, so I think maybe he's trying that serve.
It's worked twice.
Let's see if he goes for a third. It's 17-12.
The Strikers are back on TV this summer, and what a lineup we've got coming your way. We'll start with the New York Cosmos invading Lockhart Stadium on April 28th. June 12th, the defending NASL champion Chicago Sting will take on the Strikers. And on July 14th, it'll be the Vancouver Whitecaps. On August 18th, the Tampa Bay Rowdies will be in town. So join us for Strikers Soccer on TV.
Serve is an overserve. He'll get another.
Marty, I think there is something to what he's doing, because Azca before was serving more from the outside of the court. Now he's serving from the inside, so he's definitely trying something.
Okay, the second serve has to be good. Is that going to be an overserve? It is the second overserve. What a mistake that is. It's 18-12. That breaks the Milford run, breaks the momentum. It puts Miami 3 points away from victory. And you know, Steve, from serving in the middle of the court like that, I think he lost his angle and the ball's carrying further than he thought.
Yeah, and I think he's a little nervous about Joey cutting off the serve also.
A lot of strategy going on in this final few points of this national championship. Score 18-12, a six-point lead. Miami maintaining the lead. Joey approaching the line. Like to get this partido over and take that national title home with him. It's a good shot. Elorduy charging and can't make the play. 18-13. Milford comes right back and gets the point. This partido is still not over. Anything can happen. It's 18-13. 5-point lead. Azca Boninguen will have the serve.
Elorduy certainly loves to run up for that ball. Here's the Boninguen with the forehand. Elorduy knows it's going to be a high bouncer. He comes up to try and cut it off. I'd hate to see what he'd do with that ball from the seven line, Marty.
He loves to throw that devastating carom when he catches that.
He might have thrown that through the wall.
The hard granite wall would possibly crumble with Elorduy's throw. 18-13, 5-point lead. Azca serving again from the middle of the court. It's a good serve. It's a high bounce. Elorduy goes all the way up the wall to bring that one in. Azca now sending it deep. Catching Elorduy slightly out of position. Robote comes out to Joey. A good shot along the side wall. Boninguen has it. Every point being very important now at this stage of the partido. Boninguen, the ever-consistent catcher. Robote coming out. It's Joey's best shot. That's going to high bounce. And another good catch by Boninguen. Elorduy. This will come straight to Boniguin's forehand. He fakes a carom. He goes inside. Joey right in the front. Two-all placement, and that blows by Azca. It scores. That's the remate shot, getting him within 2 points of winning this partido, 19-13. Miami, 2 points away from victory.
Another good remate by Joey. Just looking for a chance. That's all he wanted. He got it right there. Bingo, bango, bongo. Good night. You can't catch that one. That was a great shot by Joey.
Boninguen keeping the Milford team into this point. all the way to the very end. Elorduy throwing a good forehand shot, driving it deep. Boninguen taking it, but Joey attacking, going to the front wall and catching it and throwing the remate two walls. Back to live action now. It's 19-13. Miami leading. Joey with the forehand, driving it deep.
Ball will come to
Azca. Joey having it now. He'll go two walls with it. Scores again, catching Azca inside. It is possible. Championship point. The score is 20-13. You can see the spirit in Elorduy as he was watching Joey score with that.
Here's the shot going deep to the backcourt. Joey faked them out. I think he was pretending to throw a courtade. Instead threw it back. The ball came out. Azca with a strong rebote. But when Joey catches it on the reverse, he can decide what he wants to do. This time he threw the remate again. Wins the point. We're at possible partido point for the Miami team.
20-13, Miami, 1 point away from the national championship of High Line. Joey approaching the service line. Azca attacking. Azca taking the serve. A change of pace, and it scores. A perfect change of pace to hot shot that keeps Milford alive. It's 20-14.
Marty, Azca took a big chance there. He cut off that serve, got very aggressive, and that hit just inches above that red pad.
That's the same shot that he threw both of those here at Miami High Line 2 weeks ago into the pad. Look at that. That ball hits.
Look at that. Just inches.
A great shot by Azca. Great pressure shot because, Steve, that was not an easy serve to catch.
No.
Outstanding play by front quarter Azca.
He cut that serve off as it was coming right off the sidewall. It's a very hard play to make.
Still possible championship point. 20-14, a 6-point lead. It's a 21-point partido. Miami gets this. It's the national title. Again, Elorduy, he puts everything he has into this ball. That ball did not touch the cesta. It's over. The partido is over. Miami has won the national championship. Joey and Elorduy have defeated Milford's Azca and Boninguen in an outstanding championship series. Embracing them, Alfredo Garcia, player manager for the Miami Fronton. As you can see, extremely excited. The crowd, very excited in this great championship match. I've never seen a crowd this excited, Kevin.
Incredible crowd giving a great ovation. Alfredo Garcia, I don't think I've ever seen him show that type of an emotion out here.
Final score, 21-14. Here's a replay of the final point.
Azca knew, first of all, he had to get this serve in. Joey preferring to let it go. Let Elorduy throw that right side. Let's keep the ball on the court. Bonnie tries to make this scoop. Can't make it. The ball came back in between the two players. And Miami is the first ever national champion. And look at the expression of Joey on that face. He knows he is one of the national champions.
A great effort by both teams, the Milford, Connecticut team, Azca and Boninguen, facing Miami's Joey and Elorduy. Joey and Elorduy winning this championship, the Miami Fronton. Final score, 21-14.
Marty, I think you'd have to say that the big difference tonight was Joey. He was here, he was on his home court, and his rebotes were good. His shots were a lot better. He was just in the previous one at the Dania Fronton. His timing was just a little bit off, and I think he just felt more at home here at Miami High Line.
I agree. I agree with you, Steve. That's definitely true. And you can see that Joey wanted this thing tonight in the worst way. And
look at this. Look at this, Marty. Joey's saying, "I am the champion." There's no doubt about that.
He loves it. Congratulations have to go out to both teams. Joey and Elorduy winning the championship. Great effort bringing it to three partidos for Milford's Azca and Boninguen. We'll be right back after this message. Final score, Miami 21, Milford 14. Let's go to Kevin Koffman in the locker room with the winning Miami team.
Thank you very much, Marty. With me are the national highline champions, Joey and Elorduy. Let's first speak with Elorduy. A tremendous effort tonight.
Thank you very much. The other night we played the semi-final and we lose because everybody can lose, no? And the only thing that I can say is we play in a team, we lose together and we win together, no? I feel very good, very satisfied, like a professional, and I hope this can be more times.
Well, Joe, this was a different team than what we saw the other night.
Yeah, we just didn't play good. I think I should take most of the credit for the loss the other day because I really played bad. But the last few days, we were working with our players' manager, Alfredo, and Lord and I have been working mentally, getting up, as well as physically and playing our game. And we went out and we really fought harder, and everything worked out really good today.
Well, it's been a long, hard tournament, but you really have earned the title of national champion. Congratulations to you both. Let's go back to Marty Fleischman.
Another great finish to the first ever National Highline Championships. Miami won it 21-14. On behalf of my broadcast partners, Kevin Koffman and Steve Bourie, this is Marty Fleischman. Good night. This broadcast has been authorized by NAJF, Miami Highline, and Dania Highline, and produced by On TV, a service of National Subscription Television, Miami, Fort Lauderdale, for the exclusive use of its subscription television audience. Any rebroadcast or reproduction of this event without the expressed written approval of National Subscription Television is prohibited. Announcers selected and employed by National Subscription Television, Fort Lauderdale, Incorporated. This has been the NAJF Championship and the Miami Highline Fronton. Tonight, On TV has presented taped coverage of Game 3 in the championship series between Milford, Connecticut and Miami, Florida. This has been a presentation of On TV Sports, a service of National Subscription Television, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.